So what's up guys, and welcome back to another video. And oh my god, did shit just go down at Bethesda's E3 showcase. We have stuff like Elder Scrolls 6 that just got announced, Starfield that just got announced, and of course a ton more details surrounding Fallout 76, and a bunch more games as well that was covered within that showcase. Of course, the main focus of today's video is Fallout 76. Again, a ton of new information, updates, gameplay footage, and all kinds of stuff was shown. And we're going to be covering it slightly in this video. I'll go over some of my thoughts surrounding some of it, but we'll probably do a bigger breakdown and in-depth analysis on all of this stuff tomorrow, or technically sometime today, because this video is going up very, very late. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and play quite a long snippet from the E3 showcase, and then we'll come back and discuss it further straight afterwards.
Good morning, Vault 76. This is the Overseer. I hope you all enjoyed the party last night, even those who may have overindulged and overslept. But it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough. Today is Reclamation Day.
Oh, finally! I feared you'd never wake up. Don't you remember? Time to leave the vault! Most of the others have already gone.
It may be time to leave, but I'll never forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family.
Goodbye! Aloha! Ciao! Arrivederci! Au revoir!
We always start with the world, and this time it features all new rendering, lighting, and landscape technology. It allows us to have 16 times the detail and even view distant weather systems across the map. Now, most people don't know West Virginia that well. It is an incredible array of natural wonders, towns, and government secrets. This is where the actual nuclear secrets are. And the quest the Overseer sends you on will take you through 6 distinct regions, each with their own style, risks, and rewards. There's plenty of cool new Fallout creatures, and we even use the folklore of West Virginia to bring our Fallout versions to life. We have always wanted to tell that story of what it will be like for you and the other characters who were first to leave the vaults. But there is one big difference with this game. It's that each of those characters is a real person. Because yes, Fallout 76 is entirely online. Okay. I know there's a lot. You have like 1,000 questions right now. So I'm going to go through them in order. Now I'll hit a couple of the big ones. First, of course you can play this solo. All right? You'll be who you want, exploring a huge world, doing quests, experiencing a story, and leveling up. We love those things about our games too. It would not have it any other way. But also, like many of you, we have always wanted to see what our style of game could be with multiplayer. So many of us talk about experiences in our games, but we've never experienced them together. So about 4 years ago, we hit upon an idea that is perfect for Fallout. Open world, survival, every person and character is real. And it was an idea that we just couldn't shake. We knew we had to do it and do it in a really big way. Now, I know you may have played survival modes in like some of our previous games or some other online games, and we, you know, people wonder, is this hardcore survival? I like to think of it maybe, it's more softcore survival. Maybe that should be a new ESRB descriptor. Death never means the loss of progression or the loss of your character. Your character isn't tied to one server. As a matter of fact, you'll never even see a server when you play. You'll be in a world with dozens, not hundreds and not thousands, of other players. It's the apocalypse. It's not an amusement park, okay? And you'll be able to join your friends whenever you want, and all of your progression goes with you. When we think about games, we think about worlds and the choices that you can make, the stories that you create and tell yourself. By creating a wide open world with very few rules, we have a game more than any game that we've ever done where the choices are yours, where you'll decide what happens. You'll decide the heroes and you'll decide the villains.
So that, of course, was the first portion of the E3 coverage, and already we have quite a lot to talk about. And they're starting off with the gameplay they've shown, and there's actually a little bit more gameplay which I'll be showing as well throughout the video. But from what we've already seen just there, I mean, it looks amazing, right? Graphically, it looks great from the second that you walk out of that vault and have that view, you know, just incredible. He also mentions as well there is 6 different regions for you to explore, all of which have their own distinct style, you know, new towns, different enemies, secrets and stuff like that. And all of that sounds and looks absolutely amazing. And then we move into the more controversial part of the video, which is the online segment. Now, of course, he does mention that Fallout 76 is completely online, so that suggests that the leaks that were coming out have actually came true. Now, he also mentions that like previous Fallout games, you can play completely solo. Now, here is where a lot of people are confused, and even myself to an extent. When you say that the game is completely online, but you can play solo, does that mean that other people are still going to be in your world, or is he talking about the game being completely solo, like you would play another Fallout game? Does it have that same feel, and does it have that same style to it? Now, to me, when he said it that way, that's what I think he meant. A lot of people seem to be confused again. I think he does mean you can play this solo like previous Fallout games, but again, the game is online. The game has complete online, you know, stuff going on. It does seem like it's built around online as well. So I don't really know how the game is going to pan out. I'm very skeptical about the game, but at the same time, it does look good. It looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. You know, you have you and a couple of friends going around questing, you know, collecting items, weapons, building bases, and it does seem like a lot of fun. Again, though, I don't know how this game's going to pan out. Does it have a full-on, you know, solo single-player feel? It doesn't look that way from the gameplay. However, the way Todd said it, it kind of made it seem that way. So, I don't know. He has left quite a few people confused, including myself. But overall, gameplay-wise, I think it looks great. And, of course, let me know your thoughts on this in the comment section below. Again, I do ask that, you know, you go into this with an open mind. I'm going into it with an open mind, too. I have, you know, a lot of questions about the game. I am very skeptical about the game. But I'm going to give it a good chance and give it a good try and see how good the game really can be. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and play the rest of the E3 coverage for you guys now, and then I'll catch you guys again after.
Look, this is a whole new world for all of us here. And fortunately, our friends at Vault-Tec have made a series of informational videos for when all of us emerge together.
As you venture out into this new American frontier, some of your fellow survivors may not be neighborly. Chin up there, sport. Not all Vault 76 dwellers will be so hostile. Find them and brave the new world together. Whether you choose to explore the wasteland alone or with friends, your days will be filled with fun activities.
You can run like a rabbit, fly like a bee. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me because life's behind you, baby.
Like previous Fallouts, you can play this game solo in Quest. But the easiest way to survive in the wasteland is to team up and build together. And in this one, you can build wherever you want. And you can also then move that to wherever you want.
After thermonuclear war, man's towering industrial marvels may no longer stretch to the heavens. What separates man from beast? It is his desire to build. Get started with camps. The construction and assembly mobile platform. Construct your home of the future. With your home secure, you can now craft handmade ordnance at your leisure to give your altercations that personal touch. It falls on you and the ingenuity of your fellows to rebuild the America we hold dear. But don't become too attached too quickly. Monitor your environment for anything out of the ordinary. The home of tomorrow may undergo certain challenges. After a crisis, work with your neighbors to ensure success. There's no I in nuclear wasteland. Document your adventures. Your memories will shape the new American dream. What's that sound? Oh dear. There goes the neighborhood.
Yeah, we love dynamic game systems. So we thought, why don't we put multiple nuclear missile sites on the map. And then let all of you do whatever you want with them.
Today's episode, Atomics for Peace. When you emerge from the comfort and safety of your vault, the world you know will have changed. Take your friendly old neighbor, Johnny. Rather than coming over to borrow a cup of sugar, he may now be coming over for murder. The time has come to seek out greater means of protection. nuclear armaments. That's right. Courtesy of your Uncle Sam, these wonders of the atomic age can be found right in your own backyard. But how does a fella like you acquire nuclear weapons, you may ask? Begin by inquiring with the locals. Gently coax them into cooperation. Use a little elbow grease if you have to. In the likely event you don't acquire a full code on your own, do not give up. Search for others who might be harboring a grudge. You'll have that nuclear launch code in no time. With the power of the atom at your fingertips, be responsible and consider your target carefully.
Attention, launch sequence activated.
Will your bomb land on a rival camp of degenerates? A random stranger? The local wildlife? Whatever your target may be, take advantage of the resulting fallout to gather rare and valuable resources. Yet these rewards don't come without risk. The fate of this new world is yours to command with the power of the atom.
We know you've played a lot of our games and a lot of online games, but this one really is unique. We have built a platform, 100% dedicated servers that will support this game now and for years to come. And look, we know this is new for all of you. It's new for us. It's a little bit scary. And to that end, we're going to need your help. Because yes, we are going to have a beta. And it is sponsored by our friends at Vault-Tec as well. The Break It Early test application. Because evidently, these online games are hard, they can have some nasty issues. I read on the internet that our games have had a few bugs. I read it on the internet, so it's true. And that sometimes it doesn't just work. Anyway, we know together that we are going to build something really special. And we also know that all of you love our special editions. And we have an awesome collector's edition for you. It starts with a map of the world that glows in the fucking dark. And it's great. It's so cool. It comes with figures you can put on the map. And it also comes with a Fallout collectible that really I've always wanted, so we made them for everybody to buy, and here it is.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Yes, all of this, the Fallout 76 Power Armor Edition. So you're probably wondering, when is this game coming out? We're excited to say that it's coming out this year, November 14th.
So So the 14th of November is when we can get our hands on this game. Now again, there is a beta that we can get involved with. There will be a link in the description down below to their website, so you can sign up for that. And I want to hear your opinions on this in the comment section below, right? I know a lot of people are against this game solely because it's online. Now, to me again, you know, from that gameplay that I showed you guys just now, it looks like it's going to be fun. It looks like it's going to be a fun game to play. Is it going to be the typical Fallout game that we wanted? Maybe not. But again, I think this game can be great. Still confused on the whole completely online, but you can play it solo like any other Fallout game part of the video. You know, it doesn't look like it's going to, you know, be a typical single player experience whatsoever. But again, I'm pretty sure, you know, that will get answered into a little bit more detail here, you know, very shortly. But again, overall opinions on it in the comment section below. I will be responding to quite a few of you guys. We are going to be going into a lot more detail in the coming videos. You know, again, sometime today I'm going to be releasing another one, and there'll be more videos rolling out in the next few days as well. As always, if you guys did enjoy this video, leave a like down below. Subscribe if you are new around, and I will catch you all later today for another video. Peace. Also, I hope you guys liked the updated version of my intro. It says 76 on the back. As you can see, there's a lot more happening to it as well. We're getting a lot more detail in there, so stay tuned for that. I know you guys love the intro. Peace.